It's not just Keith Mills in this morning either. We have a certain quarterback for the Baltimore Ravens in the studio this morning. Joe Flacco, great to have you here. Thanks for coming in.
Yeah, it's good to be here.
Yeah, we're talking about changing diapers, man. How about that? How different has that conversation gone the last couple of years, huh?
Oh, my gosh.
How you doing?
I don't like waking up this early, but it's kind of good to be out of there.
that is certainly
a 3-year-old, a 2-year-old, and a 1-year-old in the house. Woo, man.
That's rough. You getting any sleep?
Yeah, for the most part. There's one of our kids that kind of keeps us up at night, but I try to act like I'm sleeping as much as possible.
That's the way to go.
We have another special guest with us as well,
Jim Schmutz from Maryland Special Olympics is here. Fantastic to see you as well.
Morning, Brian.
Always a pleasure.
We're all getting geared up.
He's got his own parking spot up here. He's been up here so often right now.
Right.
Hey, we're talking about the Polar Bear Plunge in addition to some other things, which is a week. Fortunately, it's not this weekend. It's next weekend. But Jim, Joe's obviously been a major, major contributor to that for you guys, huh?
He's unbelievable. Since he came in his rookie year, and he talked about it, he hasn't been up to the studio. But so we're obviously blessed to have him supporting our athletes who embrace him, and he in turn embraces them and the spirit of our mission, and has been extremely supportive. So we're happy to have him here.
Yeah, Joe, it's been a big part of your life the last couple of years, I know, huh?
Yeah, well, I'll tell you what, I mean, any chance you ever get to spend time with these kids, I mean, it'll change your life in a very positive way. Just their outlook on everything and, the excitement that they bring to, every aspect of their life and, all that stuff is incredible. So, a couple weekends from now, that's a different story. The people show up and, man, they have a good time. I don't exactly understand why, because they go freeze and walk through they're probably going to walk through a whole beach of snow. Yeah. So their feet are going to be freezing by the time they get down to the water. They're going to jump in. They're going to return back up and wait an hour to do it all over again. So it's a pretty special event. And, the support that, the community gives them is unbelievable.
You've been through a lot of punishment in your life on the football field. Do you remember the first time when you went into the water, how cold it was?
Oh, yeah,
and your reaction I
had no idea what I was doing. brought maybe a towel and, walked down there in my bare feet.
You didn't wear a Speedo.
No. But I remember I was not very prepared. So I remember driving home from, back the hour. It might have been more than that year, because there might have been a little bit of snow and there might have been some traffic heading back up. I forget. There was one of those years where it was. But my feet were frozen definitely the whole entire time. And my body was pretty frozen most of the ride home, because I definitely did not come prepared. The second year, they made it a lot easier for me. They had like a trailer back there, so I could get changed inside and just hang out in there as long as I could. But I wore shoes down into the water, just because I remember the first year walking down the beach, my feet literally froze just heading down to the beach. And like once the shoes got wet the second year, I mean, they were cold, but that was only half the, that was only half the time.
That's the key. If everybody's going, you wear shoes, get yourself some scuba shoes or regular tennis shoes.
You have
shoes,
to
whatever.
Do something. I mean, I'm sure most of the people that are doing it have done it before, and they can give you tips on what they do, because they even take it to a whole nother level. And like I said, they're probably not as lucky as I am to have a trailer set up for them back at the camp.
They have a nice tent.
They're freezing the whole entire time. And that's what I was in the first year. I was in a tent and it was all muddy and everybody was getting chained because they were all wet.
Oh, you're not helping us, Joe. Come on, man. It's beautiful out there. It's going to be a nice, beautiful.
I definitely was not prepared, but man, was that a first experience with it.
That might be good for your knee this year.
Yeah, right? Put it in the ice tub for a little bit.
Yeah. How is the rehab going?
It's going well. It's just working out, going in there. I mean, you work out all off season anyway. You're basically doing the same thing. You're just doing it here in Baltimore. And, I wish more guys hung out, in the city so I could have something to do when I got done. But, it's been going really well, and, couldn't ask for anything more.
So there's two things the fans want to know. I think you know what they are. One, will you be ready when training camp starts in the season opener? And two, so how are you going to restructure your contract to make it easy on the salary cap?
Okay, well, number one, I honestly have no idea what the timetable is for this type of thing. I know I'm doing very well right now. I feel very good, and, I'm just doing it. I'm taking it day by day. I don't want to overdo anything and try to do anything too early, so I force myself into some kind of setback. But I'm coming along great, and, I don't think there's any way I'm not going to be out there ready to go right away.
Good to hear. Item two?
Don't quote me, but that's just me. And like I said, I have no timetable. I really am just taking it day by day and getting better and better each week. And then item two, I mean, come on, you know, I want to win. So I want to do everything we can to get something done. And, you know, I don't know exactly what that is or exactly what that's going to be because we haven't talked about it yet. But, you know, I know that's a huge number and it's not really realistic. So
you'll be open to.
Yeah. I mean, I'm open to doing something. I mean, I want to be here for a while. I want to play football here. So, you know, that's what it's all about.
It was a tough season. You think Ravens are close? Aberration this season, and you still feel like, hey, you can compete for a division championship next year?
I don't know if anything's an aberration. I mean, obviously we weren't good enough to win football games this year, but, you know, we have a really good football team. We've got a lot of young guys and a lot of guys that want to win. I think you can see the way that we competed down the end. You know, we never gave up, and I think that shows a lot about who we are. And I think that, you know, at the end of the day, we can look in the mirror and look at that, you know, whole experience and learn from it and grow from it. And maybe it's just what we needed to kind of get back out there and go out there and do what we're used to doing, which is winning football games.
We got a big snowstorm coming this weekend. When you were a little kid, your family, your brothers, you must have had some epic football games out in the snow growing up, didn't you? Did you?
Yeah, I mean, once we got to a certain age, yeah, we would try to find the best place we could go find. It always, in our minds, was a lot better than it actually was. You know, it was never actually that much fun when we went out there and started playing in the snow because you usually had huge gloves on and you could barely hold the football and you could barely run. And, you know, you played tackle because you didn't have to worry about hitting the hard ground and stuff like that. But by the time you got out there, it really wasn't that fun. You know, you just had images of like the handful of football games in the NFL you've ever seen in the snow. Yeah. And it just looked really cool. But when you get out there, it's not that fun.
How about you played that game against Minnesota a couple of years ago, that legendary game where you hit Marlon Brown for the game winner.
That one was fun because we won.
Was that the first game?
If we hadn't won, then it might not have been. Yeah. Oh yeah. That was the first game ever that in high school and college, you don't really play long enough into the year to play in any of that stuff. And then, you know, I've been pretty fortunate. And even in the NFL, we don't get a ton of snow during the year. So, yeah, that was pretty crazy. I mean, the whole East Coast got hit that day.
Yeah.
And the first half of that game especially because, you know, we weren't able to get the field cleared off. If we had grass at that time, the second half probably would have been just as crazy.
Are you happy about going to grass next year?
Yeah, I am. I mean, I don't have a big issue with it, but I know a lot of the guys, man, it's different on the knees to play on turf, you know, in terms of wear and tear and just everyday pounding. It definitely elevates the chance of your injury. And, you know, as far as me, it's definitely easier landing on grass and getting driven into grass than it is turf, man. You kind of bounce off of that turf and just it hurts. And grass, for whatever reason, gives a little bit more and feels a little bit better.
Hey, when you heard Steve Smith was coming back, did a smile come to your face?
Oh, yeah. Another year with him, man, is going to be a trip. And, you know, he's an awesome football player, so yeah.
Hey, yeah, along those lines, both John Harbaugh and Ozzie Newsome talked about the need for bringing some playmakers in as well, in addition to the guys you had, like Kamar Aiken and Buck Allen stepping up in the second half of the year. That's got to make you feel good to hear that too, huh?
Yeah, no doubt. I mean, I think we have a lot of guys, but, you know, we could always use that extra jolt, you know, somebody to come in here and, you know, take us to that next level. So.
Okay.
Hey, it was great to have you in. Thanks so much for being here. Thanks for all you do for Maryland Special Olympics. And, Jim, it's just fantastic to have not just, you know, a quarterback, but Joe Flacco.
Yeah, Joe's a consummate team player, and we've been talking about teams all through this plunge season. And he is a consummate team player for us and for our athletes and just a great example of what this community does. So if people want to learn more about the Plunge, plungemd.com, form a team, join a team, come out. We got a lot of work to do to get the park ready, but we'll look forward to having people next week.
If Joe Flacco can do it, you can do it. Right?
Absolutely.
Great to have you here.
Good to see you weren't on crutches or a cane walking up here today, man. That's a good sign.
No, I'm walking normal.
A lot of people will be walking
normal. I still have a handicap spot. So
traffic and weather together here on BAL.